Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I want to show you what happens when you turn off the internet in your smart home here today, show you what works and what doesn't. Now let me cue this up a little bit for you. We're going to turn off the internet first. So I'm just basically going to unplug the internet from my home and I'll leave Wi-Fi connected in my home just to show you what happens. Now, what I'll also tell you is that if you remove Wi-Fi, depending on your devices that you have, certain things will continue to work and certain other things will stop working immediately. But I'm going to show you today, Google Home, Amazon's voice assistant, or the Echo series of products. I'm also going to show you HomePod, Philips Hue, and Samsung SmartThings. So a number of major devices. I'll also tell you about some of the other devices I have in my home that are both hardwire connected and Wi-Fi or another protocol connected. So let's go through it right now. Now, here we go. I've turned off the internet and what's happened is essentially Google Home has picked up on that right away in terms of its screen. That took about a minute to a minute and a half from the time I unplugged the cable, literally just from the back of my router. Now, if I speak to either of my voice assistants, this is what I get.
I can't reach the internet right now. Check your modem or router connection and try again.
I'm having trouble connecting. I'll keep trying.
So there you go. You can see both of these have become essentially completely useless the second the internet connection is gone. And the same thing happens when I turn off Wi-Fi. Now, I'll show you that again later in the video, but we're going to start with some of the other devices in my home. So I've already tested this, and the first thing I can tell you is that Philips Hue, I'm still on my home Wi-Fi, Philips Hue continues to operate. And so I can go directly into Philips Hue right here, and there's a little light beside me, and I'm not sure if you guys can tell that. You should be able to tell it, yep. And I'm able to operate those lights again as much as I'd like, really, it seems. I can change colors, I can activate scenes, I can do just about anything I could do before. I'm on my Wi-Fi, and so I'm on my home network. So as long as your router is still connected physically to the Philips Hue, and that's a physical connection, a physical Ethernet connection, as long as you're able to get to a device that is on your home network, it will continue to operate. Now, if I turned off the Wi-Fi on this device or I didn't have a device that could access the network, I wouldn't be able to work with any of my Philips Hue products. Now, on the flip side, I have tried to log into the Google Home application. I've tried to log into Amazon's voice assistant application, my Harmony Hub, and my Nest, my Wyze cams. I have a Yoohoo air quality sensor, Miros, Harmony. None of these services are working because, and sorry, Samsung SmartThings. Both of the applications of Samsung SmartThings instantly stop working when I'm on that home network, that Wi-Fi. So, you know, I can't access any of those things. And the reason for that, and I'll show you as we walk through our house some other things, but the reason that this happens is because they're all trying to log in to cloud services, or they're all trying to authenticate you as someone who actually owns this product. So for Samsung SmartThings, although internally, and I'll show you again in a minute, internally, the functions are still working on my version 2 hub, and that's very important. A version 3 hub may not still work. I don't have that one to test, but a version 2 hub is going to continue to work. The automation you've set up will continue to work, but what will not work is the access to the services. Now, one other thing that's very interesting, and I will show you this one here on the screen, but I can still go into Apple HomeKit. So Apple HomeKit is here and it has access to two things that are very important: Wi-Fi and my home network still through my cell phone. So it's able to operate the Philips Hue devices that still are allowing me to control them. So that's a very interesting little piece there. I cannot get either of these voice assistants to work, but just based on having Wi-Fi in my home, I can go ahead and shut off that same light and go ahead and work with my different scenes and things. Now, things that have broken down in HomeKit, my Wemo bridge. It's not working any longer and I can't access my Wemo devices. Now, some of your Echo devices actually can continue to work. So you can see a list of the Echo Plus first and second generation and the Echo Show should all still work. Now, you can go in the devices tab of the Amazon Voice Assistant app and you can go into those types of devices and actually look for local voice control. Now, I don't have it and it is a very slow rollout. But this is an option to still allow you to do just a few things where you can control compatible smart lights, things like that. So something like Philips Hue that is based on Zigbee should continue to work. You can ask for the time or the date. You can stop or cancel alarms, reminders, and timers that were already set. So you can't set new ones, but you can cancel ones that were already set. So it's allowing you to continue to use some of those functions, but not at a full capacity. And then you can control the devices volume there. So that's about what you can do, but you can also ask what can you do offline just to figure out if you don't remember this list that I've just given you. So now let's go throughout the house and I will show you some of the automation and what it's still doing throughout my home. I'll show you a couple of different things that are attached to Samsung SmartThings because like I said, you can still have the automation work. It's just the fact that you cannot log into the device and make adjustments. So you can't physically interact with those devices through your smartphone any longer. So as I walk to my laundry room here, I've shown this on the channel before, there's a multi-purpose sensor and a set of Sangled Element Classic Zigbee bulbs. And you can see the automation still working as I close and open my door for those lights to turn on and off. So that automation stays working no matter whether there's internet or Wi-Fi in the home because it's Zigbee related. This is the same for the motion sensor attached to my SmartThings hub and my Philips Hue bulbs. They're all working with the automation created through my Samsung SmartThings. Now my Wi-Fi devices have all disconnected just like the Yoohoo air quality sensor. And as I ask the HomePod for any sort of command,
turn on table.
I get a very similar response from it, even though Apple HomeKit is still working. Now, as I go up to a device like a Lenovo Smart Display, which is really the same thing as the Google Home Hub in a lot of ways, as I interact with the device, which I can a little bit, but as I tap on the screen, you instantly end up with the same sort of response.
And try again.
And again, this is basically no matter what you do on the screen, there's really nothing you can do because as you tap on anything, they're asking you to use the wake word. And then as soon as you do, you get the same response. And even if you want to explore things, you're getting the same response. It becomes really, really redundant. Now, here's a multi-purpose sensor that's attached to my security system in my home. It still works, but I can't adjust whether or not my security system is armed or disarmed. So that's one very impactful thing for you. Your SmartThings security system would then stay enabled if you were just coming home and Wi-Fi and or the internet was out. So now that you've seen a couple of those things go on, the difference between internet and not being available but still having Wi-Fi and the internet being turned off and Wi-Fi being turned off, the big difference here for you as a smart home person is not on Google Home or Amazon's voice assistant, that really doesn't matter, but suddenly HomeKit is dead as well and you can no longer access Philips Hue because you have no way into the network. So essentially once that Wi-Fi turns off, you're done. The funny thing though with no Wi-Fi on is again the Zigbee network, so Samsung SmartThings, Zigbee or Z-Wave, the Philips Hue capability, it continues to operate through the Zigbee protocol. So they're not dead. They're not not working any longer. They're just not accessible from an app standpoint or from the internet. One little tidbit I want to touch on with Samsung SmartThings. So you can't log into the application and the devices continue to work. Now, why is that? There's an authentication reason for that. And this is the way that Samsung has decided to set this up. And this is based on some of the protocols they're using and some other reasons that they have for themselves. But, you know, they have a security system, or you can enable a security system on a Samsung SmartThings hub. So you have to be able to authenticate, and that unfortunately requires a cloud connection. So this is the difference, and I think it, you know, although I don't love the functionality, this is important, and I think this is why I'm starting to talk about some of these Thread-enabled devices that could switch to a cellular mode, and if Samsung included a cellular radio on their device, you could have some of this functionality as well, where it just switches over and you can stay connected through cellular mode. So that's where Thread has I think a little bit of a leg up. It's easy for companies to produce devices that essentially can still communicate through the end routers to cellular networks. So anyways, guys, I just wanted to say that about Samsung SmartThings. If you go off your Wi-Fi, you can still log in and get logged into the application, but then you're not able to see your home hub because you're not on that network, or your Samsung SmartThings hub because you're not on that network. Really, guys, I was surprised by a couple of things here. I don't know what your opinions are, but I was surprised that HomeKit continued to operate. That I wasn't really ready for. I wasn't really ready for Philips Hue to continue to work through the app because I was on my home network. I did expect almost all of them to go dead because of the need to log in. And I think this is something that we can ask these manufacturers to start to work on, because really, why doesn't a Google Home product allow you to still do certain functions? Well, that's because there's no onboard storage and the assistant is entirely stored essentially off, but you should still be able to physically interact with the device and have a physical, so turn on Bluetooth. You should still be able to turn on devices just like HomeKit, and it should still stay connected to that Wi-Fi. So why couldn't I still pipe music through my speakers if I wanted to, or play local content that I had on my network? All of these things I think should be capable with these devices. They shouldn't go totally dead and stop doing anything.